respected Sri WG, my distinguished colleagues from industry, ladies and gentlemen. It is my privilege to be a part of ASSOCHAM's fourth conference on Safe Road, Safe Life, focusing on best practices in road safety. The timing of the conference is very apt as the nation celebrates the Road Safety Week. We are all aware of India's bleak record with respect to accidents and road fatalities. India has about 3% of the world's vehicles. However, it accounts for more than 11% of the world's road-related deaths. More than 1 million people lost their lives in the last decade. The road accidents do not just have a crippling effect on the lives of victims and put them in socioeconomic distress. It also adversely impacts the economic growth of the country. Such accidents are estimated to cost over 3% of GDP per annum. Given the seriousness of the topic, Government of India accorded national priority to road safety with a clearly articulated national road safety policy. The policy is premised on a multi-pronged approach involving four E's: education, enforcement, engineering that focuses both on roadside and vehicles, and of course, emergency care. Such holistic approach is a prerequisite to achieve the country's ambitious target of reducing the road fatalities by more than 50% by 2020, in alignment with the Brasilia Declaration. The Indian automotive industry has adopted crash regulations that include provisions for protection of pedestrian and vulnerable road users. This year will also have compulsory adoption of safety features mandated by the government, like airbags, speed limit reminders, reverse parking sensors, etc. And a lot of these initiatives are driven by Daimler. We at BMW Group have always valued safety as the most critical part of our products. Almost our entire portfolio has 4-star or 5-star rating basis the Euro NCAP. And we also firmly believe that India should adopt the Bharat New Vehicle Safety Assessment Program with provisions on par with the stringent Euro NCAP. This will surely provide emphasis on safety as the key differentiators. Incorporation of advanced features, it results in increase of vehicle prices. And this may not find favor with the Indian customers who are very price sensitive. Therefore, we request government to explore possibility of lowering taxes or vehicle registration fee for these top star rated vehicles to incentivize wider adoption of safe vehicles. Globally, there are advanced driver assistant technologies, you know, blind spot detection, collision avoidance, lane departure prevention, etc., that can always be brought to India. However, there are certain constraints which actually result in OEMs not being able to get these global technologies into India. And therefore, I again request, you know, Sri Damle Saab to facilitate government support with respect to de-licensing of frequency band that can actually be used exclusively for automotive applications. Despite having world-class products and infrastructure, a lot of accidents still happen due to negligence of drivers and road users. Hence, it is equally imperative to relentlessly focus on educating, training, and continuously sensitizing them about their important role in ensuring road safety. This focus should also be on developing content and learning tools that make the program delivery more efficient, efficacious, and appropriate to various learning requirements. As part of our CSR initiatives, Be Safe, Be Smart, we engage with school children in the age group of 5 to 8 years, making them aware about the good road user behavior. In conclusion, we firmly believe that road safety is a collective responsibility. A lot of work and initiatives are being taken by the government, and I'm confident with active and able participation of all the relevant stakeholders, we should be able to realize the shared vision sooner than later. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen.